again to another episode of our weekly online chemistry class. This is episode 3 of season 6. In episode 2, we discussed the arrangement of electrons in various orbitals that we have based on their energy level. And I also told you that when you write the electronic configuration of an atom or ion, you can easily determine the period, the group, as well as the block of the element that constitutes the ion. Today, we want to look at the various rules or principles that govern the arrangement of electrons in an atom. And at the end of this class, you are expected to be able to state each of those rules often, as mentioned in the previous episode. Likewise, we are going to look at one or two exercises, how you are likely to be asked questions on quantum numbers of electrons as well as their arrangement in an atom or ion. The first rule we'll be considering today is Abel principle. This principle states that in the ground state of an atom or ion, when writing the electronic configuration of an atom or ion in ground state, electrons enter each orbital, starting with the orbital of the lowest energy level, which is 1s, before entering orbitals of higher energy levels. That means when you want to write the electronic configuration of an atom or ion in the ground state, you have to start based on the energy level of the orbitals. For instance, if you want to write the electronic configuration of lithium atom, you are expected to start from 1s2, then proceed to 2x1, and not that you start the electronic configuration by writing 2s2, 2p1. This is wrong, this is correct, in accordance with Abel principle. So the second rule or principle is the Pauli's exclusion principle. This principle states that no two electrons in the same orbital can have the same possible set of four quantum numbers. It's not possible. That is, when they have the same set of principal quantum number, they have the same set of azimuthal quantum number, the same set of magnetic, they must not have the same spin. If they have the same spin, they will either not have the same magnetic, azimuthal, or principal quantum number. It's not possible that the first set of four quantum numbers for two electrons in the same orbital have the same numbers, all true. That's not possible, according to Pauli exclusion principle. We are going to look at the explanation of that by taking some exercise later. Then we have the Ahn's rule. And this rule states that when writing electronic configuration of an atom, whereby you have orbitals with two or more degeneracy, then electrons enter each of those orbitals singly before pairing occurs. Typical example is electronic configuration of nitrogen. When you want to use Ahn's rule, nitrogen is written as 1s2. This is the orbital diagram. You have 2s2. This is the orbital diagram. And you have 2p123. Don't forget p degenerates into 3. You have 2px1, 2py1, and 2pz1, according to Ahn's rule. And not this. 1s2, 2s2, you now have 2px2 and 2py1. This is wrong. Because these three orbitals of p have the same energy, the electrons must enter them one after the other before pairing occurs. So if you have additional electron, as in the case of oxygen that has 8 electrons, the eighth electron will enter this 2px and pair it. If it is fluorine with 9 electrons, the 9th electron will enter here and pair this, while this remain unpaired. That is according to what we refer to as Ahn's rule. Now, you may have a question of this kind, that the question says you should write the possible set of 4 quantum numbers for the valence electrons of aluminium. Valence electrons of aluminium. So you need to understand that aluminium has atomic number 13. And the full electronic configuration of aluminium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. So because the highest coefficient is 3, and these 3 indicate period 3, two electrons in the 3s, one electron in the 3p. That means the electronic configuration, the valence shell electron configuration is 3s2, 3p1. So how will you now write the possible set of four quantum numbers for these three electrons? It's very simple. Indicate your principal, the azimuthal, the magnetic, and the spin. In the 3s, the coefficient here indicates the principal quantum number. That means the value of n for 3s is 3. And in this s, there are two electrons. So each of the electrons are in this shell. So you have three for the first, three for the second. And don't forget, when n is equal to 3, l can be 0, 1, or 2. So the type of orbital you have here indicates the value of l. Since you have s, it means your l is equal to 0. Okay? When l is equal to 0, m can either be plus or minus 0. So plus or minus here, you have 0, you have 0. And that indicates that the two electrons are in the same shell, in the same subshell, in the same orbital. In that case, they must have opposite spin. When this spins up, this must spin down. Now for 3p, the principal quantum number is still 3, and we have a single electron here. So the azimuthal quantum number should be 1, since we have p. So you have 1 here, okay? Your m can be plus or minus 1. From plus 1 to minus 1. So m can take any of those values, either plus 1, 0, or minus 1. So we can have plus 1 here, and we assume that the electron spins up. So because there are three electrons in the outermost shell of the atom, there are three possible sets of four quantum numbers. I want you to observe here. These two electrons have the same principal, the same azimuthal, the same magnetic, but different spin. The first and the last electron have the same principal, the same spin, but different magnetic and different azimuthal. Even if they have the same magnetic, 0, 0, they must not have the same angular quantum number. This is what we refer, and that is exactly what Pauli was trying to explain in his principle. Another example is this. Assuming you are given something of this kind, that the possible set of four quantum numbers for the valence shell electrons of an atom are, here you have 4s, 4s, 0, 0, 0, 0, plus half, minus half. And you now have 3d. This is 2. This is plus 1. You now have plus half. And you have, 3. 3 again. This is 2. This is 0. And you have plus half. You have 3 again. 2. Let's say plus 2. And you have plus half. And the question says you should write the full electronic configuration of the atom that whose valence electrons have this possible set of four quantum numbers. That is a very straightforward question. The first thing for you to do is to write out the valence shell electronic configuration of the atom. These these sets are not supposed to be there. These 4, 4 indicate that these two electrons are in the same shell, and this L equal to 0 indicate that they are in the same subshell, which is S. What S? 4S. Are in the same orbital of 4S orbital. Meanwhile, one spins up, the other spins down. So that means the electronic configuration for these first two electrons is 4S2. Okay? Now, for the last three electrons, they belong to the same, and they have the same angular quantum number, which is 2. That is D. What's D? 3D. So this one indicates that it might be DX, Y, YZ, whatever. Why this indicates that all of them are spin? You can see that they have the same spin quantum numbers, the same angular, the same principal, but different magnetic. That is in accordance with Pauli exclusion principle. So you have 3D3. This is the valence shell electronic configuration of the atom. How will you now write the full electronic configuration? You now start based on alpha principle from 1s2. So you have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then 4s2, and 3d3. They may even ask you the atomic number of the element, or you should indicate the identity of the element. If you add all the electrons together, it will give you the atomic number, which is what? 2023. And what element is that? That must be vanadium. That is another question. Another question that may be asked is that you may be given some sets of four quantum numbers. and ask whether the possible set of all quantum numbers are allowed based on quantum numbers or not. For instance, you have this set 2, 1, plus 1, okay, let's say plus 2 and 0, okay, plus half. And the question says, is this possible set of four quantum numbers allowed or not? It's very simple. This indicates the principal, the subsidiary, the magnetic, and the spin. Since the principal is 2, the angular can be 1 or 0. So this one is correct based on this. Why the magnetic? When angular is equal to 1, magnetic can either be plus 1, 0, or minus 1. So this is not correct. And that makes this set of four quantum numbers not to be allowed. Another example is this. You may have something of this nature. 3, you now have 4. You now have plus 2, and here you have minus r. When n is equal to 3, l can either be 0, 1, or 2. So 4 here is not allowed for n equal to 3, and that makes this not to be possible. And another case is when you have, let's say, principal quantum number 1, subsidiary quantum number 0, magnetic quantum number 0, and you now have, let's say, plus 1 here. That is not allowed because S only takes one of two possible values, plus half or minus half. Those are the likely questions that may be asked from the based on the quantum numbers that we have. There is what we call isoelectronic aeons. The isoelectronic aeons are aeons of different atoms having the same number of electrons and the same electronic configurations. For instance, and those aeons usually have the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas to them. For instance, the isoelectronic aeon to helium. Helium has atomic number 2. That means the electronic configuration of helium is 1s2. So what are the isoelectronic aeons to helium? In that case, you have hydride aeon. You know, hydrogen has atomic number 1, 1 electron. Hydride means it has gained one more. So it now has 2 electrons and the same number electronic configuration as helium. So another example is lithium aeon. 3 electrons after losing 1, it remains 2. Then you have beryllium. Then you have boron, 3 plus. And you have carbon, 4 plus. 6. 6 minus 4 will give you 2. So all these aeons are isoelectronic aeons to helium. What are the isoelectronic aeons to neon? 10 electrons. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. In this case, we have carbide, 6 plus 4, 10. We have nitride, 7 plus 3, 10. Oxide, 8 plus 2. Fluoride, 9 plus 1. Sodium aeon, 11 minus 1. Magnesium aeon, 12 minus 2. Once again, aluminium aeon, 13 minus 3. Silicon aeon, 14 minus 4. So these are isoelectronic aeons to helium, neon. You can also look for isoelectronic aeons to argon, 18 electrons. In this case, you can have phosphide, 15 plus 3. You can have sulfide, 16 plus 2. Chloride, 17 plus 1. Potassium aeon, 19 minus 1. Calcium aeon, 20 minus 2. Scandium aeon, scandium 3, 21 minus 3. Then after scandium, you have titanium 4, vanadium 5, chromium 6, manganese 7, and so on and so forth. All are isoelectronic aeons to argon. So in this case, in our subsequent edition, we are going to discuss how you can determine the size or how the charge and the atomic number of each of these isoelectronic aeons affect their sizes, and how you can arrange them in order of increasing and decreasing size. Because the size of an atom of elements that are isoelectronic with aeons of isoelectronics is dependent on the atomic number as well as the charge on the aeon, which is a function of the nuclear charge or the effective nuclear charge. We are going to discuss that in detail in our subsequent episode. I believe you have learned one or two things today. We are going to meet again next week. Thanks for watching and see you some other time.